100.
Bad affliction, but it's right there with boxing. A lot of the greats, domestic abuse.
Yeah.
You know, we've heard Floyd Mayweather, Ray Robinson had the same thing. You know, like, does that also fit into it? Is that just something that's, like, inherent with how violent you have to be?
And I think that's what you said. What you just said, those words, how violent you have to be.
Mm-hmm.
You don't necessarily have to be a violent person, but you have to be violent when the time is necessary. And that's a man, that's a mindset, that's a transition. That's why Marvin Hagler used to go to training camp called the penitentiary.
Mm.
He wanted to go away from everything that was nice in his life so he could be literally torture himself to get to the mindset of what he needed to do, what he needed to do. Which in the ring, he was a bad dude, man, and he wanted to hurt everybody around him. So, I mean, it's everyone has their own kind of method to get there, but you got to get there.
Is it hard to separate the two,
yeah,
the contrast? It's very, very hard. You know, some people can't, like, you know, Mike Tyson, another. Is it hard to keep that stable, to be that person? In, like Deontay Wilder, he said, there's two people. I'm Deontay Wilder and the Bronze Bomber. And he went as far to say that he wants a body on his resume,
yeah,
at the press conference.
Right.
You know, like, he said the Bronze Bomber says that. Is there that duality?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, the dichotomy of the fighter in society and then the fighter in the ring have to be different. But some guys aren't. Some guys don't shut off. God rest his soul, Edwin Valerio.
Yeah.
That guy could not shut it off. That's just the way that he was.
Yeah.
You know, and like it made him one of the best fighters that we had ever, one of the best lightweights we've ever seen. But at the same time,
he lost his humanity.
Right. He lost his humanity. Didn't fit into the society that which we live in. So you know, it is a very fine line to kind of walk. And you see it, you know, in unfortunately with a lot of fighters outside the ring.
All right. Now turning the page a little bit. Once upon a time, not too long ago, there are guys who come every era who are seemingly unbeatable.
Yeah.
We had Roy Jones, once upon a time.
Yeah, good.
Seemingly unbeatable. Mike Tyson seems seemingly unbeatable. Mayweather, seemingly unbeatable. Is there a guy right now who has that unbeatable stature? That, like, man, whoever they go in the ring with, we already know who's gonna win. Like, it just is what it is. Is there a guy like that now, post Floyd Mayweather?
I don't think so. I don't think there's ever a guy who's unbeatable.
Okay.
Styles make fights. I think the most impressive thing, a lot of people talk about Floyd. I'm a huge Floyd fan, always have been. I understand the pundits who talk about his style and how he was different than other fighters.
Uh-huh.
But at the end of the day, the man always brought his best for that one night. And for that 48 minute or the 36 minutes, he was able to find his best. And that right there is, I think, really his best attribute, was that he was able to be his best when he absolutely needed to be. So that's one of the most difficult things to do and be consistent. And I think that made him the hardest to beat because he was able to do that. But yeah, anybody can be beat, man. You see guys that are better than other guys and they lose that night.
Mm.
They could fight 100 times. They win 99, but they lost that night.
Mm.
So everybody's beatable. Everybody has quote-unquote off nights. Boxing takes an off punch. It takes an off second. So
just to pick your boxing brain, man, because it's so great. I'm watching some Paul Williams fight last night, you know, and everyone knows the rumors, you know, that was the guy Floyd quote-unquote ducked,
yeah,
you know. How would you have seen that fight? And just like when you close your eyes and you could imagine it, would he have given Floyd trouble, or would it have looked like what the Arislandi Lara fight looked like?
From a pure statistics standpoint, that fight is very difficult for Floyd because of a couple reasons. One, the reach and height of Paul Williams, very long. So this shoulder defense,
yeah,
he can hit him from further away. It's very difficult to counter a guy that's that long. Two, he was southpaw. Floyd always had a little bit of an issue with southpaw. Not saying he wasn't good with southpaws, but he did always have a little bit of an issue with southpaws. Three, Paul had hand speed too, and it was a volume puncher.
Mm-hmm.
So you got a long, strong, fast volume puncher. That's a difficult task for anyone, which everyone who fought Paul Williams will say that.